Let's begin by turning on the computer. While the computer boots up, turn on the ShopBot. Open the valve on the main air assembly. You will hear a gentle hiss. Now turn on the ShopBot control box. You will hear another hiss. Grab the spindle interlock key and turn it on. Now log into the computer and start the ShopBot control software. This error message you see here is typical and does not indicate that anything is wrong. Now press the blue reset button on the e-stop pendant. This resets and activates the ShopBot motors. You'll know the motors have been reset when you hear the spindle fan turn on. To start the homing routine, go to the control software and select Cuts, C1, Home Table. Type Y and hit Enter to begin the routine. The spindle will lift off from the skirt block. Grab the block and place it out of the way. All ShopBot operations are based on moving to precise X, Y, and Z coordinates. Those X, Y, and Z coordinates depend on a consistent origin or home. The homing routine is how the ShopBot finds that consistent origin. The ShopBot needs to be homed every time it is powered on, after any crash, or when the control software is lost. If the position displayed on the screen changes, but the spindle doesn't move, then the control software is lost. When the dialog box prompts you, grab the calibration tool from the shelf. Remove the empty tool holder from the box, as seen here. Now hold the green button and insert the empty tool holder. Then, release the green button and attach the clip. Now, press OK on the screen. Once the machine finishes its routine, it will return back to you. Take off the clip and return it. Now hold the green button and remove the empty tool holder. Go ahead and put the calibration tool back inside the box and place it back on the shelf. Run the spindle warm-up routine if the ShopBot has been idle for more than 4 hours. Go to the Cuts drop-down and select C2 Warm-up Spindle. To start the spindle, press the green button on the e-stop pendant. Look for the spindle to start after pressing the green button. Now load your material properly. The machine is ready for the job. Once the job is finished, go to Cuts and select C5 Drop-Off Tool. Once the tool has been dropped off and the spindle has returned to you, place the dust skirt block directly below the spindle. Use the control software to lower the spindle within an inch or so above the dust skirt block. Now turn off the control software, disengage and remove the spindle interlock key, and turn off the control box. Place the key back on the hook. Close the valve on the main air assembly. Notice that the spindle falls on the dust skirt block. Then turn off the computer monitor, and that's it. You're done.